who walk around with big Jesus on the cross still and the big crown on his head because he the high priest. And the book of Romans says they hold and suppress the truth, the word of God, okay? So that's why you can't grow in your walk with God. That's why your Christianity ain't going no further than where it is. Christianity, Christ, I anti. Why would they give you a religion, tell you, ooh, you love your Jesus, serve your Jesus, but the word Christianity is Christ dash I dash A-N-I dash T-Y. That's Christ I anti. I don't give a damn. You got an extra I in there, so what? They play with words, I'm trying to tell you. They took Christ, made a Christian word out of it, made a Christmas word out of it, and made a religion word out of it. Now, if that ain't blasphemy over your Lord and Savior Jesus, what the hell is or isn't? If that's not blasphemy, then what the hell? That's blasphemy. They took your Savior's name, made Christmas out of it, made Christian out of it, and made damn Christianity out of it. And that's the anointing of God we talking about when you use the word Christ. So why mock the name of Christ like that? Oh, because you couldn't do it with Jesus. Jesus must don't sound right. Being Jesus-shin. Like, you know how you be a Jesus-shin? You be a Jezebite? Yes, what the hell? You be a Jezebite, a Jesus-bite, a Jesusite, or something like that. You can't do it with the word Jesus. So they take Christ, the anointing of God, and turn them into these horrible words. Christian is not a Christian. People who follow Christ was a follower of the way. The Greeks gave you the word Christian. Hell, they gave you all your damn words. They gave you all your damn words. Most of the words in the Bibles is Greek. When you look up the words, everything got a Greek definition. Why? Why? When Greeks did not was the first people with God's word. That's just simple history right there. Nope. They give you all this stuff to worship. And you just run around here like, yes. I'm about to show you what got us so bogged down. We got us so consumed. We so caught up with all this other stuff they done put out here in the world. But that leaves me, is Jesus really the reason for the season? Or they tell you Jesus is the reason for this season so they can get rich off your ass? It don't matter. I buy Christmas gifts and give and give. It don't matter. I'm just calling it like it is. We all been caught up in this for so long. And like I said in my other post, I was raised to say Merry Christmas, but now I'm learning that how come how come every other holiday say Happy Holiday? Happy New Year, Happy Valentine, Happy St. Patrick's Day, Happy 4th of July, Happy Columbus Day, Happy Halloween. When it comes to Christmas, they want your ass to be merry. Because they know they mocking your God. They know they know they dissing you. They want you to be merry about that. Father, have mercy on me. I know what God is saying to me and how it's coming out of me. And I'll be quick to say, Father, I repent if I'm wrong. Ain't nothing wrong about this. Every other damn holiday is happy. Except for Christmas. Yeah, it's supposed to be merry because this is the season, right? Christ is the reason for the season. So ain't Tammuz. So ain't the evergreen tree. And so ain't Satan. That's why they want you to be merry, because they mocking. Remember the Bible said, be not deceived. God shall not be mocked. And what the hell the first thing they do? In Acts 11:19. You don't know I know my Bible. You better stop it. Acts 11:19. They start a church. Call you Christians. Mocking your God. Come on. Christ ain't supposed to have no other labels attached to him but Christ. the anointed one. Not every Christian is anointed. Hello. And like I said, how am I going to be diehard loving Christ, but I serve the Christianity. Break that word down for yourself. Christ, I, anti. Christ, I am against, damn it. Who is you to tell me I'm against Christ? Because you doing this right here, you doing against Christ, but they'll make it seem to the world they for Christ. Because they come out once a year and say, baby, Jesus is Pope. No. Baby Jesus, bone in the manger. Wasn't no room for him in the end. Was he black? Was that why? They ain't want to take a black baby Jesus in the end? So you kicked him out. Thank God for some cuts, right? For them tents. Thank God for temples back in the day. But these people done distorted us. Like, I keep telling myself, I'm black. It's a Greek Bible. And I'm speaking an English tongue. You too? You couldn't figure out why you was a little bit crazy, maybe just couldn't line up with the word of God. Things just like wasn't right. You had questions, you felt out of place with certain things the Bible was saying and asking you to do or not do. And I went to God, like, God, you got to show me. I'm not listening to another pastor. I'm not listening to another person teach me. God, I need to hear from you. And you could do the same thing. You could do the same thing. You all could do the same thing. Go to God for yourself. Because we've been religion week. And Santa is one of them. It's Satan all day long, y'all. Satan all day long. Satan, Satan, Satan all day long. They just switched the word. They say, oh, we're going to give you a religion. We've been telling you Satan your enemy all this time. But we're going to give you a holiday on your Savior's birthday. We can't call it Satanmas. We have to call it Christmas, Christmas. And make you think you're worshiping Christ. But really, we're going to give it to you like this. We're going to give it to you like this. You, one way or another, you people that we sold into slavery, you people going to serve Satan. Satan wants you to worship him. See, that's bullshit to me. Because God gave me a free will. God said, hold up, Drew, you can serve me or you can go a whoremongering after other gods. Yeah, he say that in the Bible. He said you serving other gods, you fornicating, you whoremongering, you doing all this stuff. Because I told you in the book of Matthew, through Christ, serve no other god but me. Do not tempt me, and man cannot eat by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. And who mouth is who mouth? Is the Bible really the mouth of God? When it tell you not to eat pork, and then Peter tell you, who is over the Roman Catholic Church, it's okay to eat pork. He said he had a vision. And God said, anything I say is clean, is clean. When God spent five books plus 100 and something other, but he had major prophets, minor prophets. He had harlots and Harabs and Rahabs all telling the people about the commandments of God. What to eat, what not to eat, what to do, what not to do. And then Peter come along and tell you to eat pork. Is that why he got crucified upside down in the Roman Catholic Church? Because he disobeyed God? You better start to ask yourself some damn questions. I could go on and on. I'm going to give you 17 more minutes and I'm done. I think I've been on here too long talking about Satan Claus. This is Satan Claus. Santa Claus. Satan Claus. Damn Satan Claus, man. And you running around here. I don't get it. Look, you can change it. You can still celebrate the fact that you give gifts with your